I've edited your puppy like twice now. Are you a blogger or do you have business too?
Vlogger. Yeah, basically just make videos.
Okay,
and,
okay.
Emily is taking over. I'm Kelly, and we are at Rave Palooza.
Hi. So that's why we have our website set up.
Yeah, he's busy, so I'm taking over this live.
Yes. So
this thing works awesome.
Hello, hello. I don't have much to say. You can see right there. Many people, and look at that salt mountain.
Yeah,
and
I'm in charge of saying
this. I don't know, like I don't know anything about corals, so let me show you what's going on right here. Hi, oh, he's back, thank God.
It's not that easy, huh? To like blah 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 blah.
It's like asking you to do live in a talk show. Can you say anything?
Okay, let's see the comments. Okay, really, this is gonna be a really short live, and I'm gonna let you guys drive. What do you want to see? And we'll go there. What's going on, guys? Adam said that it was here. The SBB booth was unreal. Oh, here.
Oh, the shirt. Yeah, awesome. I pick it.
We got the SpongeBob. That's SpongeBob. That's Patrick. Emily picked it. When she looked at it, I'm like, you're crazy, but apparently she's the smart one in the relationship. Okay, Gates asks, let's see your favorite booth. Ooh, that's okay, I know which one. My favorite booth. There's like favorite booth in terms of design or favorite booth in terms of the corals that they have. Let's see the most expensive coral. And here we got Joseph. We'll be back. My favorite booth. Here, let me slap on the orange filter. Sorry, it's getting a little packed here, so I want to make sure I don't get in people's way. Got to be considerate as well. One second. So I'm gonna flip the camera. I think in terms of like favorite booth, it's these guys right here. I got the orange filter on. And the reason I really like this booth, sorry. The reason I really like this booth because they have this blackout canopy, right? So everything looks really darked out. And when you're actually in front of the corals, it's really quiet in there. Because as you can see, things get a little loud in the convention center. But when you step in front, it's like a whole little different world, almost like a little storefront. So this worked really well. And it just feels like I wish more booths will take notes and do something like this. I do see other canopies around, but a lot of them are still kind of like over the open top. It's just like a little table space right here. So I really like that. It shows off the corals and really well. And just easier to talk as well. I don't have to scream. All right, let's keep moving. I saw some amazing corals that I could take you right away because I saw that somebody asked about corals. They're not really the most expensive, but I was impressed. I think it's over here. There's Will. I did not. I saw that. There's like an empty hole. But I saw some of these corals you have here. That looks amazing as well. Okay, I'll need to get Richard to get some clip. But from a distance, we see. I can zoom in. That pink one looks really interesting. What is that guy right there? The one in that little cup.
Neptune
Bounce, okay. Godzilla's that big one right there, right? The green one?
So. I think Richard took like 100 photos of that bounce gully.
Uh huh.
When he first got here, it was the first thing we got,
and
had all the bubbles
floating again. Nice. I've not seen a bounce gully before. How much was that going for?
6,000.
Oh my. Wait, did you see he sold it? I'm in the wrong business, man. Here, let's come over here, take a closer look. Yeah, I thought this looked really interesting, right here.
The Neptune Bounce.
And the Godzilla looks really cool too. Also, that right there. Absolutely beautiful. All right, we'll continue the tour. Thank you, Will. look. Yeah?
There's a coronavirus there.
Oh, jeez, man. Another really impressive. Here's Jimmy Going Places. This guy does a lot of video for Mobile Coral. Beautiful. Lightweight setup. I thought you roll around with like a DSLR, but apparently this is enough, huh? Doing excellent work for WWC. Alright, so these two booths got some of the, in combination, some of the most impressive corals that I've seen in this show. But let me go ahead and put the filter on and we'll wait for a little gap to slide in there. Okay, I think we got it. Alright, so check this out, guys.
Wow.
Look at these guys. I wish I can tweak the white balance a little bit more in YouTube live mode, but you get the idea of the kind of meat corals that we got going here. Absolutely amazing. And that Euphilia tank, it's even more impressive, but we got people watching there, so we'll swing back. Another booth that I really enjoy this time is actually Pacific East. Oh, these are big too. Look at these big boys.
$400.
$400 for the light, right? Yeah, for the light, only one tank.
Wrong focus. I was like,
that coral's gonna be more. Don't cost more. That's beautiful. Here, just walk this way. There's Scott. No more maxing out. He's legit.
We're maxing out. We're double dosing. You got max out on one side.
Okay.
This way, we got the other side. We keep on.
Got it. Keep on.
We're mixing it all up tonight.
Got it. And we got the whoopee. All right, Pacific East. Stronger. Oh, there we go. All right, we're back. Here, check this out. There's some giant clam. And I'll say our dog has been really popular this show. Here, we'll come back. Yo, how's it going?
But I watch all your videos, man.
Thank you, I appreciate it, man. Of course, of course. Here, I'll get a picture too. Going live right now, actually. So you can say hi to the guys.
What's up, guys?
Here, let's take the pics. We'll bring them in here too.
Got the viewers and everybody in here. Awesome, thanks Rob. Yep, thank you.
See how popular Kowloon is? There's Cat. That's the end. Okay, oh, there's the opening. Let's check out the clam. So yeah, that definitely more of a crowd this afternoon. All right, never mind, forget it. Can't get in there. All right, we'll go this way. We'll come back. Let's see. We got some cornhole going. I thought the CCHE display, it's amazing. Really enjoy this one, actually. There's something mesmerizing about just staring at it. And this booth is actually really interesting. Every Reef Palooza, right? I really enjoy it. It's like a collection of different tools for reefing. And it lots of seemingly random collection, but there's a lot of really useful tools. For example, we got the blue picker that I often use. We got these longer tong, that's really useful as well. And we got like pointers, a lot of just random tools that's useful. But let's walk this way. I really wish I could show you guys the Pacific East Agriculture Clam because look amazing, but we'll see. Another booth that I've really enjoyed, it's Clammania. You see, I've been focusing on clam. And we got John right there. And John constantly had people just walking in front of his booth and just seeing what's going on. I can't exposure compensate. But basically, he got a bunch of like baby clams. This time, we got Maxima clams, Corsica clams, as well as thoracic clams. And it just non-stop stream of people. And John, as always, happy to drop some clam keeping knowledge. What's going on, Lynn? I got to hand him like push away. No way, I can't do it. Fonfrax, where's your booth, man? Yeah, Fonfrax, I just got to come here. Here, let me see if I can focus on you. This guy has been like high energy the whole time. Hey, how's it going? Hey, how's it going?
That's you, huh?
Oh, I'll try to give you guys, I guess most of you guys have probably seen the Neptune sky. I had a bit of time to kind of like look at it, play around with it. It's quite a nice light. And these are the new ones too. It raised it way high. Tank and corals are for sale. It's nothing can really beat the shimmer. Beautiful shimmer. Gorgeous. But it seems like this year, quite a few vendors are able to bring in clams, like larger clams, which is cool. And here we got the Fritz Throne getting taller and taller each year. Let's walk this way a little bit. Got frost corals, always a crowd favorite. We got the marine biologist right here, Reef Nutrition. We'll come back. That's cool, new skimmer coming out, new media reactor. I'll go over them a little bit more in the video, so look forward to it. And we got the gingerbread. And you guys probably know him from Coral Fish 12G, George Corals. George's video, sorry. All right, let me make one more attempt to go into the Pacific East aquaculture because those clams look nice. I really want to show you guys. All right, let me scroll off a comment real quick. Fonfrax, are you vaccinated yet? Yep, vaccinated, but since we have a kid at home, figure we'll be safe and just wear the mask. E-shops. Oh, Shalom. Every time I see him, he's either sitting right there or on his phone. Look at this guy. If you guys are on Instagram, you know this guy. Sneak up on him. Also, proximity alert, right? Exposed in 4K. The boss hired me to check.
You know why I get you this shirt? So that I can find you easily.
Oh, that's funny. All right, let's see. Hi, how are you? Try and go back to Pacific East Aquaculture because they have some nice clam right there.
People ask for the most expensive coral here.
Yo, I really don't. Oh, okay. Oh, he is? No, he's not.
People love them.
I guess most expensive corals will. Like you just mentioned, yesterday there was a bounce trikey, is it what it is? What he said? Sold for $6,000. So I guess that was the most expensive one.
Okay.
Okay, let's see.
Buy five, get five free.
Let's see. Oh, that sounds like a really good deal.
Yeah.
Buy five, get five free. That's why his deal almost sold out. And that's why there's a crowd. Okay, guys, one more time. Let's see if we can make it into Pacific East Aquaculture. Oh, I see a gap. All right, one more time, we're gonna put on our orange filter and we'll make a go at it. Oh, here we go. All right, Pacific East Aquaculture. Whoa, saltwater aquarium, thank you. You guys have a booth here too, we gotta swing by. But first, since we finally made it here, let's take a look. So, Dr. Mac, Pacific East Aquaculture, the facilities at Ocean City, Maryland. They're kind of local to us, been wanting to visit them. Reloading, eh? Reloading.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Look at that St. Thomas. Look at this goat torch. Okay, yeah, that's the one I want to show. Look at this guy. Oh my goodness. Look at the size of that. It's Bombosa.
$600.
Yeah, that's it.
And look all the way over here. We'll swim around there. All right.
What's up?
Oh, that's not loud. What's going on, dude? Did you just got here? For those of you who don't know, this is the Duke of Corals, or the meme god of the reefing world. What's up with this?
I got a chorus right now. I just got here.
Wait, is this buying or is it selling?
This is buying.
Buying, okay.
Tired.
That's fine. Hey, how's it going? It's me. Man. What's that?
How's the dog enjoying?
Seems okay. he was beat. Okay. But yeah, if you guys are not following this guy on Instagram, that guy creates some really quality memes for the reefing community. Alright, we're just gonna walk around a little bit. Alright, let's answer some questions and I think we need to make our way to Saltwater Aquarium actually. And also Farm Frag. Oh, can you show the SPB corals and Jason Fox? I remember Jason Fox that way, so we'll definitely do that. Let's see. Can you tell Duke to unblock me?
Huh?
Is it Duke from the Coral Club FB group? Lens not lined up, uh-oh. SPB Coral 521. And also, someone else. 521, how do I know the group number?
It's 214 right here.
Okay, we want 521, so it's probably on the other side, right?
Yeah.
All right, per your request, let's go. And I think I just did a big lap. We're right back here. Here, let's walk. That's a cool container, boss. Neptune. Neptune Sky. Pretty impressive to look at. Really reminds me of T5. Also, I have the ONF Flat 1 light that gives off similar kind of light quality. It has a diffuser panel. I like it. Yeah, he just got a haircut right before coming. Before that, he was like a big mop. So this worked out.
This is an ad.
Oh man, look at all the raffles.
Look at that.
Yep, we talked about that as well. Beautiful living wall. And we got terrarium set up here. These are carnivorous plants. A lot of them. We got some pitcher plants here. Well, let's keep walking.
Oh, that's so cool.
511, right? So let's keep going that way. Ooh. I want to show you guys the Euphelia tank as well, but looks like that's a crowd, so. 511. Oh, here, 522. Is this 5? Here's Will again.
I'll check out your show. That sounds cool.
Oh, here, SBB. Hi, how are you? 521. All right, per your request, let me clip on the lens. Line up, right? Like last time people were like, yeah, things are not lined up. All right, let's give it a try. Thank you. Oh, is it okay if I borrow one of these two?
You can keep them actually.
Oh, really? Thank you. There's double up. There you go, because I couldn't adjust my white balance while live streaming, so this works. Look at this. So, yellow filter plus orange slice. So, this is here. Let me just move on to make sure people know where it is. Beautiful SPS, man. Let's slide on over there. Gorgeous mushrooms. Okay. Actually, this one. Yeah. Emily knows. Emily was like, this looks expensive. Is this a Chicago sunburst?
Yeah, it's a Colorado sunburst. Yeah.
Oh, Colorado, sorry.
Yeah.
How much? I say the same thing, Chicago sunburst. I get it mixed up.
You visit Chicago, that's why.
Yeah.
What's up?
How much is this go for? 900? Actually, price came down. Normally, they're like 1200. That's a good deal. The size, too. Fueled up. That's beautiful. That's $900. Blue Basin Aquatics, if interested.
Get it.
No.
It feels like it's coming
the weekend
for you, bro. Right?
Beautiful. Look at his collection. Like Adam's like, that CSB is fire even without the orange filter. Look at that. Thank you. Here, let's keep it here. We have some at home. Thank you. All right, saltwater aquarium. What number? I don't think you dropped a number. Yeah, if you want that CSB, $900. Yeah, in contact SBB. Hi, how you doing? Ooh, let's take a look.
Yeah,
I like this booth. This looks great. It looks beautiful. 5 of 100. Right here. Come on. Here we got people reeling and dealing. Richard or David or Moki, however you want to, like buy five right now.
Yeah.
Four for one, four for what? 120? Two for 60? Five for 100? Wait, these are different.
Those are different kinds.
Okay. Oh, this guy got his own blue light to check the color. That's smart. Oh, full ocean. How about some bracelets too? They have canvas shoes now. They look really awesome.
I remember you gave one to me.
Yeah. Yep.
And I lost it.
Thank you. Hi, how you doing? Deal. Okay, let's take a look. Got some nice Zoas here. For 50, great deal.
Exciting,
yeah. Yep, yes, sir.
You remember?
That's right.
Awesome, goat. Thank you.
Oh, he's coughing. He's coughing.
There's Moki. Hey Dave, not bad. Hey, I want to ask you, which one is your favorite booth? Because usually you give up. Actually, are you doing that award this year or no?
No, this year I skipped because I wasn't sure how the story went out.
Yeah.
So I wanted to see the feel of it, and then maybe for the next one, however, we'll have aficionado rap.
Yep.
Okay.
All right, so unofficially, do you have a favorite booth this year or additional? Just vendors. For vendors. Everybody.
I was pleasantly surprised
Okay.
So that there's food. He had a lot of pearls, which surprised me. I'm like, oh man, look at that. That's the school.
Yep.
I'm like, oh my god, look at that bottle of pearls. I'm like, I don't even know. I was like, my next one. Because I was so impressed by that pearl, you know?
Yeah.
Actually, honestly, one after the other, I was like, oh, this is nice. Oh, this is nice. Oh, my God, I need to get out of here. It was
he was really proud of that coral that you mentioned, and that went for $6,000, bro.
I have this thing.
Dude, he mentioned that yesterday afternoon. He's like, you have to come check it out before I sell it. I did not swing by and it was gone. So I'm kicking myself. So, excellent. Reefs.com, right? When do you think the video of your cover should go online? Tomorrow. Got it. Awesome. All right. You guys heard it from David.
FarmFrex.
Thank you, sir. All right, we'll move on. Bye, David. Man. All right, let's see. Hey, puppy. All right, so any last minute requests before we sign off? I think we're thinking about potentially going to New York real quick for a quick spin. Don't know yet.
Huh?
Maybe, I don't know.
You're only a bubble tea, man.
Let's see. I'm not sure if somebody at Saltwater Aquarium actually is here that's watching it or is To be honest, I haven't walked down this aisle. I should really want to talk to Hannah, Kevin, because they recently released the nitrate high range checker that I'm curious about. Although Kevin looks kind of stressed out. He looks kind of stressed out. Is either he's stressed out or is party too hard last night? Yeah, comment below and let me know what you think it is.
And tag him.
Saltwater Aquarium. Freddy Boo Boo. Did I? Oh wait, there's more stuff down there. I guess whoever's watching right now is not here. I do, like boots on the ground per se. Let's see. Oh. Let's see. Okay, he's helping somebody. We'll come back. But there's Kevin. And he looks stressed. Hang in there, Kevin. Hold on a second. Wait, what? Saltwater aquarium? Freshwater aquarium? Wait, I didn't know you guys do freshwater. What's going on? Hold on a second. Is Hannah Instruments part of... Is this... What is going on? So this whole thing, no problem. The whole thing is Saltwater Aquarium booth? I thought it's like three different ones. Okay, let's keep going first. Let's make sure we're not in the way. Interesting. Wow, okay. Hey, what's up guys? Sorry, I'm not the best at tracking comments right now. But Fang, how you doing, man? Miss you. Usually you're here too, right? People want to see Ecotech. Totally fine. We'll swing by. Okay, all right. Let's swing by Ecotech. That's at the front door. Along the way, we can check out two little fishies and we'll call it a wrap. Wrap. Get it? Oh, he's so funny. John's booth's always so busy. And Mr. Julian Sprung was giving me a lot of tips on how mangrove actually, how to actually grow them properly. Oh, look. And hopefully he is. He totally is. Crop favorite. And hopefully Mr. Sprung is going to write a book to update on all the mangrove cares. Yeah, I learned a lot. I really appreciate you taking the time out this morning. All right. I'm going to slide over here real quick. So, some new things. Actually, before we get into new things, check out this mangrove grow. Look at the prop roots. Beautiful. Looks like he sold a lot of them too. Looks like a lot of them got sold.
Yeah. Only one left on the
Oh man, he's beautiful. Beautiful.
Yeah. Well,
3 years, right? That's like 5 years.
Oh,
4 years? 4 years,
2 years for these. Some of them are in a year, year and a half. This is 6 years.
6 years. Absolutely gorgeous.
They don't all produce so many lakes like that. I have no idea why some of them just do
it. And well?
It's doing well. And the way you present it, I think it's perfect. It's really nice. And this is the main one, right? The original trunk?
That's the original propagule right there.
All right, thank you. I'm going to take them to check out your new reactor. So two exciting things I saw is number one for the nano keepers, right? They actually make a nano version of the media reactor. This is their normal one. And the story goes, I think Sky's Lagoon, if I remember right, next door. They actually DIY'd it, cut this in half to make a smaller reactor for use on smaller tanks. And Mr. Sprung thought it was a great idea. So they actually got the dimension from them and make a smaller version. So that's number one. Second thing, I think there's people in front of the booth, so I probably cannot really show you. I'll try to zoom in. Actually, I think we got a little. So the second thing I'm really excited about is actually these guys right here. These are rigid scraper. There's no flex at all, not plastic. So these would be perfect for like scraping the back of the tank. As you can see, my tank is pretty deep, 30 inches. And then there's overflow box in the back, so I cannot use a magnetic scraper. So this will come in really handy to straighten back. And they should be out in 2 months or so, if I remember correctly. So it's like little tools like this, you don't think about too much until you use something that could be a little bit better. So I thought this would be this is a nice addition.
Put your hand in there.
This had a soap box, I think. That was weird. I mean, that is metal. That is metal. I did not really get to ask what kind of metal it is, but I'm sure if they use it, it's not going to rust. Ecotech. Let's see. There's something new about Ecotech. I think they're showing the Neuro 3, which is gone. Yeah, but they used to have like a demo unit here. It was pretty cool. I didn't know it's like a magnetic thing. You can actually undo the whole thing so you can kind of aim it differently. But what's most important, you guys see the Versa right there? See, if you had Reef Palooza right now, you could have bought it. They got single head and quadruple heads.
I know every people is speaking.
Sorry.
What are you doing?
blocking out. And of course, we got to show Worldwide Coral, the event organizer. Always really popular. They got some nice merch too. Hey, how's it going?
Are you going to be here until 6?
No.
Oh, bought these and we had to leave. I forgot.
Oh, sorry. We're probably gonna head out soon. Thank you. Can we see your number? Can we see your number? Just curious. It'll be interesting to see if. Okay, here it is. All right, if you guys hear this number, got it.
Nice meeting
you. All right, nice meeting you, man. And this brings us back. Mr. Chad, you're not chugging phytoplankton this year. Not chugging phytoplankton this year. This is this is the healthiest reefer I know. This guy go like long distance, do Ironman stuff. Ooh, man.
He's working with weights on his legs right now, you know?
I wouldn't be surprised, man. It's probably like strap some. All right, thanks.
I'm going to follow you and then give you a theme song.
All right, last call for any booth you want to see. Otherwise, we're going to sign off. I like that, actually.
We got two monkeys here.
Okay, let's go this way. I think we can... We got the outro playing. I like that. Outro playing as I walk out. go see Gingerbread's right here. Let's see, can we squeeze in there? Hey, how's it going? All right, no, pop on your own food.
Is it working?
It's working. So per your request? It's interesting, they have a controller now on frac tanks. I like that, that's a great idea.
We need to get closer.
Closer?
See the color.
Beautiful. I feel like you guys sold a lot of stuff already, yeah? I see a lot of empty slides. Yeah. That's a good thing. That is awesome.
Yeah.
After the afternoon rush is coming too, so. Question.
Yeah.
Probes in your frac tank, is this something new that you're doing or you have been doing it?
Wait, what's that?
Using like probes to monitor your system?
Yeah, FTMS drops them off for us. It helps us like kind of explain what their product is and how it works and all that. And also it's kind of nice because then we can see what, you know, we can check on fusion, like what all the parameters are.
Do you see like actual big swings as the day goes on, now that you have the data? Okay. You haven't looked at it yet, okay. I'll be curious, because you're doing a lot of volume, water goes out. Yeah, figure. Got it. Yep, I get that. All right, thanks so much, man. Sorry to like jam a camera in front of you randomly. Thank you, I appreciate it. And here's a little bit of puppies. And I'll try to catch the last bit of comments. DC Reefer, what's going on, Warren? I was just talking to O. I heard you have a little bathroom issues and a little plumbing color decision issues. But fun is part of the journey, right? All right, I guess time to go. All right, hey, thanks, man. Appreciate it.
See ya.
Oh, wait, Jason Fox. I think it's way back. All right, sorry, man. Not walking back there. I apologize. I know somebody wanted to watch Jason Fox. I think I got some video on his booth, so that will come out. But dude, it's what, like 3:30? If my sense of time is correct.
No.
We gotta start heading back. We gotta start heading back. Yeah, and my fingers are tired holding the phone. Okay, let's see here. Hey, see you. And here's walking out. Oh man. I can give you my quick thoughts as we walk out of here. There's Jimmy going places. I think Jimmy's here to stay. He's not going places. He wanna go.
Same here.
Jimmy going home. Jimmy go home. All right, man. See you guys. Oh, these are smart men coming for the deals. Now's the deals. Deal time. Hey, have fun. Akita's like, where's Leon? Who's Leon?
Oh, the first question that we ask is, are you inappropriate reefer? The second question is, where's Leon?
A lot of people were asking, where's Leon?
But who is Leon?
Okay, so a little bit more serious, like us two are vaccinated, he is not. So be on the, to err on the safe side, right? Figure we'll just come. Got a mask on, just in case. And he's not, so he's staying with grandparents.
Out.
Yeah, there's nobody here, we're outdoor, we're good. All right, so here, find the thoughts. It's overwhelming when I first got in. Like first went in at like for about 2 minutes, I just had to go in the corner and just take it all in. And she can attest to it, us filming as well, but it's not acting, like legit. I was like, oh. Number one, it's been a while since I've seen so many people in kind of like the same settings. And number two, like the last brief Palooza, or just Big Show, felt so far away, but at the same time, it felt so familiar, if that make any sense at all. And it just, it's nice. It was nice. It's like going back home, right? It's a good feeling. It's a good feeling. And now I had a little sit down chat with like Lou and Vic a little bit later as well. Learn a little behind the scene of like what it takes to put things together, and it gives you a little bit more appreciation of like big shows like this. So it's kind of cool. Insane Reef, are you going to Rapalooza? Probably not to Chicago, because I've been to Coachella, Chicago. So we kind of tour the city a little bit. We like it, but I feel like we'd like to try to. The way I see these shows, like besides the show, it's also an opportunity for us to visit different places. So we would actually do the, if we're talking about Coachella, probably the Dallas one, Dallas, Texas. But again, we'll see how the situation is at that time, go from there. Reef Bum is here. Reef Bum, how are you doing? Sorry, I did not, not really tracking the comment too well. So, hello. Wait. Is Reef Bump still here? Or did, was it there yesterday? Sorry about that. Totally missed. But yesterday I arrived really late. I arrived at about 5 o'clock. We left the house around 11, I think. The drive was supposed to be 3.5 hours, but they're just like delays.
No, you're delayed. My brain delayed.
So we arrived late, but we stayed at the Aloft Hotel around here, and it was a really nice day. I would definitely recommend that hotel.
Where is Leon?
Yeah, Leon's my parents. So we're gonna go back, pick him up. TC Reefer, get the home wrecker. Come on now. Then it'll really become a home wrecker if I really got it. All right, guys, I think that's pretty much it. I apologize for not putting out a video this week. Here, let's we'll wait for the helicopter to pass first. Oh, that's cute puppy right there.
Tree.
No. So I apologize for not putting out a video today. I'm also working on something for my dad for his birthday that's coming up. That's taking a little bit of time, and of course we're here as well. So instead I thought we'll just do a quick live stream. Been a while since we chatted together. And I think next week I should be able to put together a video. I'm not sure if it's going to be this one, because this one's going to take a little effort to cut together. But it should be a good one regardless. I have a lot of contents piled up. I can't wait to share with you guys. So with that said, I think we're going to sign off, eh? Here's Kowloon. I'm sure you guys much prefer to look at my dog and Emily than this mug right here.
Not really. All right. Like corals.
Yeah, I gotta get some coffee. All right. Y'all, thank you for tuning in. I appreciate you guys. See you guys next Sunday, 12:30 p.m. sharp.